What's up, guys? So last night I did three parts to a video talking about what's going to happen from 2020 to 2027. I actually don't know for sure, but that's what I think will happen or believe. Anyway, let's talk about one important thing that we all need to know and keep in our minds. In these last days, just before Jesus returns, there will be people that are on the fence, and Dad mentioned this in a video on my other channel. On the fence, meaning they'll be on two sides, they'll be double-minded. They will want... Look, here's the thing. You can't worship two, okay? You can't follow two. You can't be all for the world and all for Jesus. You have to choose one or the other. And because we have double minds and we constantly go back and forth on whether we believe or not, because that's what on the fence means. It means we kind of believe, but we're not too sure. And there are going to be a lot of people that have fallen away from the faith that are on the fence, that are, you know, questioning if they even believe anymore, if Jesus is ever coming back, or if he was ever real to begin with. But Jesus is coming back, and this is proof that he's still coming back because he prophesied this very thing just before he returned. You can't be two-sided and expect to win people over to Jesus. You can't be for evil and preach against it. You can't do that. Because if you do that, and this is a warning, the Pharisees were hypocrites. They started preaching against some things, and they committed those sins that they preached against. Jesus said that they were like clean bowls, all beautiful to look at, but on the inside they were filled with dead man's bones. They looked holy on the outside, but on the inside, they're just as crooked and corrupt as the rest of the world. And those are the people that you want to steer clear from. They were hypocrites. They blasphemed Jesus. They accused Jesus of blasphemy when they were committing the sin themselves. So you're going to have three kinds of people in these last days. You're going to have people that wholeheartedly believe in Jesus, that he's coming back and have faith in him. And you're going to have people that are on the fence that are like, I'm not so sure if I believe in this Jesus guy. There are some things that don't really make sense. And you're going to have the third kind of person that is all against Jesus and is all like, I don't believe in Jesus. He's not real. I don't believe him anymore. I'm going to go sin now and make myself feel good. Those are the three kinds of people you're going to find these last days. My recommendation, be the one that trusts wholeheartedly in Jesus, because that's the one that is going to be saved in the end. It says, he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And Jesus said that Jesus is the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through him. So there you go. Jesus also said in the last days, will I find faith? And you have to have faith to please Jesus, because Jesus is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. That's a message for the church right there. The reason why the great outpouring hasn't happened is because most people haven't made up their mind and their decision on who they're going to trust in these last days. Are they going to trust Jesus, or are they going to trust the world? Sadly, a lot of people have decided to trust the world, and they're going to pay in the end for it. But don't be two-sided, because that holds you back from letting the full purpose that Jesus placed you in this life from coming to pass. It holds you back from being the person that you were called to be by Jesus. So what's your choice? You can't expect to go to heaven and half of you be on the world side. You just can't. You have to be all for Jesus or all for the world.